This is Editing Eva. Before we jump into this week's video, it turned out a little bit different than what I had planned for. Different in a good way, I think, I hope. This was supposed to be a video about me building a very big windowsill for my houseplant, and it still kind of is. But while I was filming the footage for this video, I came across a story. A very beautiful story, the story about the flower bike man. I had no clue whatsoever that we even had a flower bike man in Amsterdam. So I did a little bit of research and last minute I decided to make this video a little bit less about me and my windowsill and my building skills and a little bit more about a beautiful story. While I was filming the footage for this video, it was not clear to me at all. I was wondering, who is this flower bike man? So at the end of this video, I will be back to tell you a little bit more about his story. Today I have a very fun video planned for you guys. I need to go to the DIY store to buy myself some MDF because we are still building a huge windowsill for my houseplants. I need this MDF to build the inside of this windowsill because right now you see some very ugly radiators and a lot of radiator pipes, and by magic we are going to make all of that disappear. And I am very lucky that the small sheets that they sell are big enough for me to use, because my only way of transportation is my bike. I do not own a car. I do not even have a driver's license. And maybe this sounds a little bit strange to you, but in the Netherlands and especially in Amsterdam, this is not a strange thing at all, because Amsterdam is the city of bikes. Am I going to be able to bring all of this MDF home by bike? I'm not completely sure yet, but we are going to find out. And I was thinking maybe it would be fun to share some interesting facts about bicycles and Amsterdam. And also, on my way to the DIY store, I want to show you some very interesting bikes. Did you know that there are 900,000 bikes in Amsterdam alone? We have more bikes than we have people. The average person owns 1.4 bikes. So how does that work? Well, probably the 0.4 bike is a spare bike. Maybe it is missing some parts and maybe that's why it is 0.4, I guess. People in Amsterdam do not ride very beautiful or expensive bikes, because if you blink your eyes for just a second, your bike is gone and you are never ever going to see it again. If you can find yourself a very decent but also very ugly bike, you are the king or queen of Amsterdam. Here's also where very interesting bikes come into the equation, because if you have a bike that is very quirky and looks very strange, your bike is not going to get stolen. The thief has to put so much effort into changing your bike into something mainstream, something sellable. It is the perfect day for a little DIY store trip adventure. I'm going to show you some bikes that are completely over the top, and I really hope that I can manage to bring home all the building materials that I need. It is going to be interesting. Interesting bikes in Amsterdam are not that hard to find, and you can even take a look at yourself in the mirror. This is a bike that I really like because somebody did so much work on this bike. It is full of very cute little Dutch houses. On the back over here you have a Dutch windmill. Another little house over here. This little thing is also very cute because a lot of houses in the center of Amsterdam actually have something like this. They used it in the past to hold things up because the houses are very tall and the stairs are very narrow. So they had a pulley system and a hook and you could bring all of your furniture up like this. Lots and lots of flowers. Flowers are everywhere. Using flowers to decorate your bike in Amsterdam is a real thing. There are all kinds of things hiding away in this bike, also on the inside, and I think they are actually doing some work on it because it looks a little bit messy right now. Normally there are more houses on the inside of this bike, but I guess a bike like this needs maintenance now and then. Over here is another bike that is really completely over the top, full of flowers. There's also a little basket on the back, maybe for a little dog or something. It is very cheerful and very colorful and very creative. As you can see, the wind is blowing pretty hard, so I really hope that you can hear me. Red flowers, red bike, red basket on the front that is saying police, do not touch. This bike also has a mirror. I'm not completely sure why though, so that's interesting. Very interesting. There's also a sign on the back. Let's see if I can read this. Flower bike man. So this bike belongs to the flower bike man. That makes sense to me. Next to the red bike, we have a bike that is completely silver. It is very reflective in the sun because they have all of these little mirrors attached to the bike, and also little disco balls. More flowers on the front and also a little basket. Very handy. The next bike is more simple. It is completely covered with daisies. They do actually have a real plant on this bike. It is not looking great. I think it could use a little bit of TLC, but a very brave attempt to start a real garden on a bike. And a very big sunflower on the front. The little sunflowers on the wheels. Here is a bike that is very over the top, completely covered with flowers. I think it is amazing that people put so much effort in decorating their bikes. This one has a very practical mirror to see what's behind you. And there are also some light bulbs down here. This bike also has very big flowers on the wheels. I'm not completely sure if this is a bike that is actually used. I think maybe it is more just for fun. This bike also belongs to the flower bike man, but it is a trash bike, I guess, because that's what it is saying. And there's a big collection of trash everywhere. Trash on the wheels. Trash over here in some sort of a fishing net. This sign over here is saying that you can absolutely not park in front of this bike. If you park in front of this bike, you are going to get towed. And what is even more funny is that you can actually make phone calls over here. Of course, it is not a real working phone, but still very creative. I think this is the most creative bike I have seen in a long, long time. I think these bikes belong to people that live in tiny little boats over here. I really love this area. I love the water. There's also a very interesting boat over there with a lighthouse on it, and all of these houses are floating on the water. And over there is the very big river, the River Ey, that is separating the north of Amsterdam from the center and the rest of Amsterdam. I see another very interesting bike. Do you see it? This one has a very big blue butterfly and also a very cute little bee on the front of the bike. It is a bee with a little wiggly head. This bike is also saying Flower Bike Man. So this is an artist that decorates bikes. And I think he also tries to put a little message on the bike. This bike is saying love all animals. So I think every bike has a little bit of a theme going on. And I think these bikes are actually not meant to be used. I think it is more an artistic statement. But there are a lot of people in Amsterdam that also have decorated bikes like this. And that also actually use them. So I have found myself a nice place in the sun that is a little bit more quiet. So let me read to you a few fun facts about bicycles and Amsterdam. If I can read it, because the light is bright out here. Fun fact number one. In total, there are about 513 kilometers of bicycle paths, separated bicycle paths in the city of Amsterdam. So that's a lot of bicycle paths, and they also all have their own stop signs with little bicycle images. And the stop signs for the people that are by foot go a little bit sooner than the stop signs for people on the bicycle, because people by foot of course are a little bit slower, so they get a little bit more time to cross the street. Fact number two. On average, a person in Amsterdam cycles about 900 kilometers per year. Every day, all people in Amsterdam together cycle 2 million kilometers. Even the king and the queen of the Netherlands sometimes use a bike, and their children actually go to school by bike. And I think a big part of those 2 million kilometers are made by children that go to school. Fact number three. On average, 1,000 bicycles per hour pass through many places in Amsterdam. So let me show you a little clip so you can see how it actually looks when 1,000 people pass through a certain place in an hour. A very fun fact number four is that Amsterdam actually has a real bicycle mayor since 2016. The bicycle mayor is the cyclist voice at City Hall, and this forms the link between the cyclist and the city. My toes are sleeping, so many facts to cover. Fun fact number six. The bicycle flat in front of Amsterdam Central Station is the most famous and most photographed bicycle park by tourists. 2,500 bicycles can be accommodated at this three-story high storage facility. On a working day, 9,000 bicycles are parked around Central Station. And of course, I can tell you so many more fun facts and stories about bicycles and Amsterdam, but I really have to go to the DIY store. I will put a very nice video down in my descriptions for you to check out if you want to know more about how everything works when it comes to bicycles in Amsterdam. They are out of MDF. It is finished. I need this one.
Then it's not finished.
Yeah, but this is in the wrong. Oh, then I need this one.
Oh. You sure you don't need the next one there and there and there? And there?
Maybe I need all of them. Yeah. But I think what I really need is to go to a different DIY store. So, are you up for that? Yes?
Yeah, let's go.
Okay, let's go. This DIY store, these sheets of MDF, are €2 more expensive than in the other one. But I guess you pay for the fact that they have it.
Yeah, true.
Okay, if I'm lucky, I also have enough for the top of the windowsill, and this is the right thickness, so that's why I'm buying this. Okay.
Moet ik even helpen?
Nee.
Oké. Okay.
So that's how we transport things on a bike. The question is right now, can I ride my bike or do I have to walk?
Ooh, 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 ooh. Is everything going well?
Yes!
Oh jee!
Very windy! Well, that was not the easiest bike ride ever, but it was definitely not the hardest one, because I have brought home things way bigger and way heavier on my bike than this. I think I actually have enough for underneath the windowsill, but also for the top. The only question is, did I really buy the right thickness of MDF? I think this is going to be very hard to see, but it is absolutely exactly the same thickness as the windowsill that is already here. I think I have everything I need to finish this windowsill except for the little edge that is going to be underneath the top of the windowsill, but I really could not buy that today because it was complicated enough to bring all of these MDF sheets home. So who is this flower bike man? Well, his name is Warren Gregory. He was born in America, and I actually found a little documentary about it. I will link it down in my descriptions, but I will give you a very short version of the story. I think it is very clear to all of us that this man likes to decorate bikes, but why? This whole story started with his wife because she has very bad epileptic seizures, and this is something that is hard on its own. But she also has a lot of problems with her memory. One day, his wife came home very upset because she parked her bike outside Central Station and could not find it anymore. And I told you about the 9,000 bikes outside Central Station. It is hard for anyone to find a bike there. He went out to look for her bike and he found it, and he decided to place a very big sunflower on the front of her bike, and he told her, "Now you are never going to lose your bike again. You will always be able to find it." Besides losing her bike a lot, she also had a lot of problems with finding her way, also finding her way to work. So he decided to place another decorated bike full of flowers alongside the road to help her to find her way. And I think this is such a beautiful story, and I am not a very romantic person, I have to be honest about that, but this is just a very beautiful romantic gesture to do for your wife. And after that, he never stopped decorating bikes. His bikes are all over Amsterdam, and the bikes that I showed you are not the most beautiful ones because they are quite old and they have been outside for a few winters. Some of his bikes are absolutely amazing. They are little pieces of art. And the reason why he is decorating these bikes still is because he wants to share positivity and love and happiness. So he places these bikes in areas that need all of that, industrial areas or places where something sad happened. And I think it is a very beautiful thing. There are a lot more videos about him on YouTube. There's also an Instagram page and a Twitter account. And you can find all of those things by typing in #flowerbikeman. So I really hope you enjoyed watching this video. If you did, please do not forget to like, comment and subscribe. Next week, we build. So I really hope to see you then.